Tyrannosaurus rex is considered by many to be the deadliest terrestrial predator to ever walk the Earth. This gigantic carnivore ruled our prehistoric world during the late Cretaceous period, between 68 and 66 million years ago. T-Rex was so large and its jaws so powerful that it crushed the bones and devoured the carcasses of many giant Cretaceous dinosaurs. Beyond its terrifying bite, T-Rex had surprisingly keen senses, with eyes as large as grapefruits and oversized olfactory regions in its brain. This keen sense of smell likely allowed T-Rex to track prey efficiently, detect open flesh from great distances, and possibly even recognize kin or mark territories. However, this dinosaur's reputation has cast a large shadow over the many other theropods that have lived on our planet. While T-Rex ranks among the biggest and strongest, other species reach similar sizes and were extremely formidable in their own right. In particular, a relatively unknown terrestrial predator may have been even deadlier than the tyrant king, likely feeding on giant herbivores that most theropods never dared to approach. This predator's name was Mapasaurus, a ferocious carnivore that lived in the Neuquén Basin of Patagonia, roughly 94 million years ago. Like many theropods, it is often confused with Tyrannosaurus rex, though Mapasaurus belonged to an entirely different family called Carcharodontosauridae. Carcharodontosaurids have several distinct skeletal characteristics that distinguish them from other theropods. For example, they had large serrated teeth, similar to those of great white sharks. They also had distinctive skull features, including rough nasal bones and a complex system of sinuses and air sacs in the skull. Plus, they had strong forelimbs with three-fingered hands, unlike the reduced arms of tyrannosaurids. Many diverse carcharodontosaurids lived on our planet during the Cretaceous period, but Mapasaurus was among the largest, in some ways rivaling Tyrannosaurus rex. Though these two predators would never have met, they grew to similar sizes, measuring roughly 12 meters long and 3.8 meters at the hips. Mapasaurus probably had a more agile frame, weighing roughly 5 metric tons, whereas T-Rex weighed around 6 to 9 metric tons. Both animals also had oversized heads and powerful jaws. T-Rex's bite force was probably stronger, at around 35,000 to 57,000 newtons, while Mapasaurus had blade-like teeth, adapted for slicing through flesh. On the surface, it's hard to see how Mapasaurus surpassed the tyrant king of the dinosaurs, but during its peak, it may have been the most dangerous dinosaur ever, in large part because of how it may have hunted. For many years, paleontologists have debated whether giant theropods hunted alone or in groups. After all, the only thing scarier than one of these carnivores is a whole pack of them charging forward and snapping their humongous jaws shut. In science and media, giant theropods like T-Rex are usually depicted as lone hunters, fighting over food and territory with other members of their kind. With some limited evidence, a few paleontologists have reimagined T-Rex as group hunters, but most experts still consider them to be solitary predators, using their size and powerful bite force to take down prey individually. However, for one giant, toothy theropod species, the evidence for group hunting is considered stronger. As you might have guessed, that dinosaur is Mapasaurus. This stems from a critical discovery from the Huincul Formation in Patagonia, Argentina. There, a team of paleontologists uncovered not one, not two, but at least 7 Mapasaurus specimens buried in the same bone bed. Not only did these 7 specimens come from the same time period, but they also belonged to Mapasaurus at different stages of development, ranging from juveniles to fully grown adults. At first, scientists wondered if these fossils ended up in the same location by chance. However, the proximity of these specimens and their different ages may suggest they belong to a single roaming group of Mapasaurus. If this interpretation of the fossils is correct, Mapasaurus was a gregarious animal and possibly the largest pack hunter to ever live. The Huincul specimens aren't the only reason to think Mapasaurus hunted in groups. Consider for a moment the evolutionary advantages of pack hunting. Animals generally hunt in packs to increase their chances of survival when solitary hunting strategies aren't as efficient or effective. Wolves, for example, hunt in packs so that they can trap and kill animals like bison that are otherwise too large for them to fight on their own. Pack hunting also increases the odds of catching prey, which is especially important in biomes where prey is less available or harder to catch. In these harsher ecosystems, solitary predators may struggle to find food. Pack animals, on the other hand, can hunt over wider areas and, therefore, obtain more consistent meals. In the case of Mapasaurus, pack behavior may have given this dinosaur a huge advantage in an ecosystem riddled with natural challenges. During the late Cretaceous period, its habitat in northern Patagonia was mostly hot and arid, with an unforgiving seasonal climate. For most of each year, long dry periods limited the growth of forests and tropical vegetation. Fertile pockets sometimes sprouted along the banks of rivers and lakes, but in this ecosystem, food and water were generally harder to find. The animals that thrived in this dry environment included large roaming herbivores like sauropods. These humongous animals were very efficient eaters with long digestive periods, allowing them to get maximal nutrition from their food. Their size also made it easier for them to travel between pockets of vegetation. A long trip for some animals was only a short walk for these gigantic dinosaurs. Because they were so well adapted to their environment, sauropods like Argentinosaurus spread all over Patagonia. Herds of these long-necked animals roamed the open plains, shaking the ground wherever they walked. For predators, a group of sauropods may have looked like an all-you-can-eat buffet, but killing one of these animals was a task few predators could handle. Argentinosaurus, for example, was one of the largest and heaviest animals in the history of life. Adults of this species grew up to 35 meters long and may have weighed over 70 or 80 metric tons. If their sheer size was not intimidating enough, these animals also had strong, pillar-like legs and an enormous, whip-like tail that may have been used in defensive scenarios. Thanks to their size and strength, adult sauropods were highly resistant to predation. Some predators targeted younger sauropods, but even that was a challenge. Adolescents were sometimes surrounded by their parents and other adults, who outweighed even the largest predators by a huge margin. As a result, solitary hunters stood little chance of killing these towering animals. But predators like Mapasaurus may have learned to work together. In today's animal kingdom, group hunting takes many forms. Sometimes it's less coordinated than people expect. Certain aquatic species, such as piranhas and black-tip sharks, will sometimes engage in a chaotic feeding frenzy. Each predator attacks and feeds independently, without much coordination. This mob-like style of feeding is also occasionally observed in Komodo dragons, especially when a particularly large animal, such as a water buffalo, is wounded or dies. On the other hand, there are many species notable for more coordinated styles of hunting, such as grey wolves. Wolves use a combination of stealth, stamina, and teamwork. Once a target is identified, the pack coordinates to isolate and surround it. Some pack members chase and test prey, while others flank and then converge for the final attack. Wolves use their powerful jaws and sharp teeth to bring down the prey, often targeting vital areas like the throat or hindquarters. This cooperative strategy allows them to take down animals much larger than themselves. In the case of our toothy theropod, we have to make some educated assumptions, because much of paleontology is not definitive. We can't say with absolute certainty whether Mapasaurus hunted in groups, or if they did, exactly how these groups were organized. What we can do is make educated inferences based on the best available evidence. But since the evidence for group hunting is greater for Mapasaurus than for most other theropods, let's explore the hypothesis that groups of Mapasaurus used a cooperative approach to take down giant animals like Argentinosaurus. Imagine them working in unison to divide and scatter herds of sauropods. Amidst the chaos, these predators may have isolated young, weak, or physically injured individuals who were vulnerable without the protection of the herd. This would have required patience, but as prey animals go, sauropods were worth the wait. If a group was successful, one sauropod carcass may have fed an entire group of Mapasaurus for days or weeks at a time. As they tore apart a broken behemoth with their razor-sharp teeth, each Mapasaurus would have gained the nourishment and energy required for the next hunt. Mapasaurus was one of the most successful predators in South America, but it wasn't the only giant hunter on the prowl. Mapasaurus was closely related to another famous predator named Gigantosaurus, one of the largest theropods of all time. This impressive animal lived in a nearby region of Patagonia between 99 and 95 million years ago. Like Mapasaurus, it preyed upon large herbivores, rising to the top of its food chain and dominating its ecosystem for millions of years. There is no evidence for group hunting behavior in Gigantosaurus, but they were undeniably terrifying and captivating apex predators. Ultimately, there is a lot we don't understand about the behavior and intelligence of giant theropods. While recent evidence suggests that some species, like Mapasaurus, may have hunted in packs, the definitive truth about these animals remains hidden deep below the surface. If they were truly group hunters, they may have been the most dangerous terrestrial predators to ever live. But so much of what we know about Mapasaurus, Gigantosaurus, and T-Rex comes from limited fossil evidence. All it takes is one big discovery to rewrite the past and transform our understanding of how they hunted and survived. As we unearth new fossils and trackways, we may discover these giant predators were more impressive than we ever imagined.